stop. Are you wanting to create a fillable form like the one you see here, where people get to enter in information and then have to save it and then upload it and then send it back to you? Well, then this video isn't for you, because in this video, I'm going to show you how to turn any document or PDF into an actual online form in just minutes, so you don't have to waste your time collecting and reviewing each PDF one by one. Instead, you can collect information in real time in a table like this. And best of all, you can do all of this absolutely for free. So let me show you how. To get started, we're going to go over to jotform.com and make use of their smart PDF forms. Now, the best thing about this is that you can turn any PDF or document into a fillable form. It will convert it in just a matter of seconds. And not only can people access it on any device, have you tried filling out a PDF on your mobile phone? But you can collect that information in an easy to use table, but keep your PDF format. So let's go up here and we're going to say try now. And we're going to create our first form together. Now, you don't have to start with a PDF. You can simply start with a doc or a docx. And you don't have to put in anything complicated either. Let me show you what I mean. In my example, I'm going to be using this PDF, which I simply created in Google Docs. And you'll notice that nothing is fillable here. In fact, these are just underscores on my keyboard. I've simply included the different headers and the different areas that I want to be filled in. And then I just used underscore to create a line within this document. Anyone can do this in Google Docs or Microsoft Word, or if you want, you can take an existing PDF and do this as well. So going back to my Jotform account, I'm simply going to select Upload Document, and I'm going to go find that exact PDF that I just showed you a moment ago. And not only is it uploading it to my account, but it's actually going to convert it as well. Yes, you can see here on the right-hand side, it's already created a fillable form here. This is my original PDF, but on the left-hand side, it has already gone ahead and created a true online form for me to start using. Now, it may not be absolutely perfect, but all we need to do is make a few tweaks, and then we can send people this actual form, which is linked to my PDF, and make it that much easier for both them and also myself. So here, starting on the right-hand side, we have our original PDF, and you can see that it's already identified the different areas that we need to fill in. And in fact, if I click on any of these, it will help me in showing which thing it has linked to over here on my online form. So if I click on, for example, this date area here, it's gonna draw a simple little line and sort of highlight these two things together. And yes, it's even correctly identified things that need a date field, the start date, the end date, and then down below here under the signature, this date area as well. Now, of course, it may not be absolutely perfect, but Jotform makes it very easy for us to edit this. For example, there's two things that I'm going to want to adjust. Number one, it didn't seem to pick up on this fixed price amount. And number two, here you can see that it has identified this signature area, but it's not a signature box. We're going to change that here as well. Let's start with this fixed price amount. So under my deliverables here, I want to add a new element. So up in the top left-hand corner, I'm going to select Add Form Elements. And here's the variety of different elements in which I can add to my form. Now, you may think that I want to add a short text field. It's not a bad idea, but we're talking about numbers. We're talking about pricing. I don't want to allow people to add in text or to write in a name. I only want to allow them to add in numbers. So I'm going to choose this number element here and simply drag it onto my form. And then here at the top, you can see I can match it with what is the area going to be on my original PDF. And yes, of course, it's going to be my fixed price amount. So over here under number, I can say this is my fixed price amount, so it matches with what's on my PDF over here. And now within this field, they can only enter in a number when they enter in their pricing amount. Now below, you'll see that we have this freelancer area here, but I really want to collect a signature instead. So what I'm going to do in this case is I'm actually going to remove it. I'm going to come back to my add form element, and you will notice that yes, we have the ability to add a signature. So I can place it in here. And yes, we can drag and drop these elements up and down to wherever we need to. Once again, on the right-hand side, I'm just going to drag it over here to my signature box. I can change the length or the size of it if I need to. And perfect. I actually don't need to do anything else. It already has the signature title here, so they know what to do. And now people can go ahead and sign this form. Now, in my example here, I'm happy with a fairly basic form, but don't forget, you can add your own logos if you like. We can come over here to the form designer panel and change our entire theme if we want to add colors and change our fonts and everything else. But for this example, I'm going to keep things relatively basic. The next thing that we can do is come over here to our settings, and if we want to give the name a particular title and look at some of the other integrations or maybe some of the other options that we have available to us. One of them could be the thank you page, for example, if you want to give a customized thank you or perhaps redirect them to somewhere else on your website. But let's get to that publish phase because I want to show you what this is going to look and feel like for the people that you send this to. Here we have our custom link, which I'm simply going to copy, and let's paste it into our browser, and this is exactly what they will see. So again, you can choose whatever title you want here. It's actually going to show the original PDF so they know that they're getting an official document, or perhaps they've used this document or seen this document before in the past. I'm going to select Start Filing, and now we have this actual fillable online form, which they can access on any device. And best of all, they don't have to remember this complicated date format. We've actually given them something a lot more convenient, like a calendar date picker here. Here they can enter in their name and other deliverables that need to be provided. Remember our fixed price amount column here? I am attempting to type in letters here. It won't allow me to because I want them to only add in pricing information. And then yes, we have that signature field, which is super easy for them to fill out as well. Now, down below, they can submit it right away, but they can also preview the PDF as well. And this is the additional bonus because it's giving you and your clients the best of both worlds. Not only can they easily fill out this PDF, but here you can see they can have a saved copy for themselves. Here are the dates in which they filled in. Here's that fixed price amount. And it even has their signature, which is date stamped at the time in which they signed that document. They can go ahead and download and save this document if they want, or they can go back to the form and then hit submit at this case. Now, jumping back to my JotForm account, I'm going to select the form that we just created and I'm going to select submissions. And here I have all of that information available to me, including their signature, including everything that they included. Now, as those forms are filled out, I get to view and collect and analyze all that information in a helpful table. No more do I have to open up the documents which they've emailed or uploaded to me and look at each and every individual field. Trust me, the days of fillable traditional PDF forms are over. Now, to get started creating and converting your own PDFs to online forms, just go to jotform.com or click the link in the description down below. And if you have any other questions on how you can simplify your software and make things easier for you and the people you serve, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.